many issues are there on the cards. Definitely, we will be discussing about the border and the boundary issue with the Honorable Minister. We will also be discussing about many of the developmental issues that are there. The Honorable Minister, Home Minister, being the Chairman of NDC, so we will also be discussing about that. He is also very keen to discuss about the afforestation and conservation work, especially in Sora area. So we'll be discussing about that. All the chief ministers of the Northeast have been invited. So I'm sure that there will be some agendas that will be very common to the whole of Northeast that may be discussed. Apart from that, obviously, state-specific issues, including our issues of the 8th schedule, issues of the 6th schedule amendment, issue of the ILP, all these matters will also be discussed with the Honorable Home Minister. But as I said, a lot of homework has gone into what how we plan to move forward in this. But at this point in time, as I said, it will not be proper, you know, to discuss those details. But as I said, we are focusing basically on the fact that whatever solution we come up to must be an amicable solution and must be also some solution that is going to be acceptable in large, you know, to the people of both the states. So we're trying to work on finding out if there can be a mechanism in that line. So obviously, all the aspects of historical facts, constitutional issues, you know, the population there out there, all these factors will be factors that will come into play. But then ultimately, how we will come to a solution is something that we are working towards. And as I said, it's not easy. It's an issue that has been there for 50 years, but we want to give it a try to find if we can find a solution and a way forward in this. In the MDA meeting, the partners have obviously asked about this. They all expressed that institution of the committee has been done, so we will wait for that report of that. They asked for some clarifications from my side. I gave some clarifications. Which, of course, in the course of the inquiry will come out. But since the inquiry has been set up, so it would not be appropriate for me to mention that here. But after they heard all those clarifications, a lot of them understood what the situation is. And they have all clearly mentioned that it is a matter that has to be decided by the Chief Minister. So they are not pressing for it in any political way or anything like that. These are incidents that happen, should have been avoided, shouldn't have happened. There's no doubt about that. But to link it to saying that it's militancy coming back or it's you know, this kind of power that they're having would be overestimating the entire thing. Yes, there are concerns. And as I said, these are overground workers. The action has been taken on that and will be taken. And further, we will continue to neutralize anybody who tries to disturb the law and order in the state. We are increasing the monitoring and the intelligence level to ensure that these kind of incidents don't take place. But as I said, a lot of cases have been there. We have ensured that many such incidents don't happen, but then once in a while, there is a slip and it could happen. But yes, we'll ensure that more intel is put into this entire activity. But as I said, there's a procedure and the process that has to be followed. And the most important part being that they have to shun violence and lay down their arms. So that is the most important thing. And obviously, whatever discussion takes place should be within the constitution framework of the country. So that's these are a few basic things that need to be done. But yes, efforts are on to discuss this matter.